the French construct a massive siege tower, which they move up to the dry moat. It's said to be taller than the southeast tower of the Outer Bailey. To understand exactly how a siege tower works, I've come here to Malbork in Poland.
Wow, you don't see one of these every day. A full-size replica of a medieval siege tower.
Bartek Stysinski built this medieval megastructure. It's 5 stories high and engineered for an attack on a grand scale. Siege towers were so heavy that oxen were often used to move them forward.
Is this where they would charge across onto the wall?
This is the place where we have a battle bridge used by the knights just to attack the walls.
But the defenders on the wall, they'd be shooting back. Is that why there's wooden planks here?
Yes, of course. Just to avoid the archers from the walls.
So it's a bit like a kind of tank, isn't it? It's protected, a way of getting up close to the enemy.
It was the last chance for the attackers just to came very close to the walls.
So how do you use it when you get close to the wall? What happens here?
They prepare the battle bridge just to pull it on the walls.
But so this goes down like a drawbridge?
Yeah, of course.
And then the knights run across there?
Yeah.
That's dangerous. You feel exposed.
One floor up, archers provide cover for the soldiers storming the wall.
So the battle bridge goes down, and
yes,
we've made sure there's no one else on the other side because we're shooting them.
Yeah.
It's an amazing integrated system. These guys are providing covering fire for the knights below. It's brilliant.
Yeah, that's true.